A severely disabled man critically burned while left in the shower at this care facility. Now police are investigating and his guardian wants answers.
This is inexcusable.
Good evening, I'm Melissa Fry.
And I'm Adrian Whitsett. 22-year-old Donzel Harden suffered third-degree burns on the lower half of his body at a Bellevue group home on Saturday. Right now, he's in the Nebraska Medical Center's burn unit.
KETV NewsWatch 7's Michelle Bandur is live with more.
Melissa, Donzel Harden's guardian is making a tough decision inside the hospital tonight. Take the chance to see if Donzel will make it through a painful skin graft surgery or be on a ventilator or just let nature take its course. She tells me that Donzel shouldn't be suffering. She says all of this could have been prevented in the first place.
Born prematurely, Donzel Harden has been severely disabled his entire life. He's blind, doesn't walk or talk, and is unable to use his arms.
His birth certificate says he's 22, but in reality, he's 9 months old.
Sherry Becker brought Donzel into her foster home 10 years ago. In 2009, she put him in a Bellevue group home, Hands of Heartland. Friday night, paramedics rushed Donzel to the hospital with severe burns. Police say a certified nursing assistant left him alone in the shower while she helped a coworker on the computer.
He was being scalded and couldn't do anything. He can't move. He can't even cover himself.
According to the police report, the CNA placed Donzel in his shower chair, turned on the water to let it warm up, and moved the shower head away from him and left. When she came back, the shower head was now pointing at Donzel with scalding hot water.
If she'd been in there with him, she would have known the water was getting too warm before it got to the point where it burned him.
The owner of Hands of Heartland didn't want to go on camera. However, Courtney Klein Hayes tells me, quote, "This is an isolated incident. There is one person involved. We're conducting our own internal investigation." She says, "Human error happens. We have put in safety measures to make sure this doesn't happen again. We have contacted all the state agencies we are supposed to, the Department of Developmental Disabilities, Health and Human Services, Adult Protective Services." For Sherry Becker, she waits at the hospital and hopes Donzel will recover to live the life he had before.
This is a situation where it was preventable, and I want something put in place so this doesn't happen to other kids.
Now, the police report also says that it appears the water heater was set too high. However, Becker tells me that's a moot point. She says Donzel never should have been left alone. Again, police are investigating the situation. Reporting live, Michelle Bandur, KETV NewsWatch 7.
Thanks, Michelle.